finding the elevation and the distances when the base is inaccessible. Okay, suppose we want to find out the RL of Q. And the base is inaccessible from the our stations. So how can we find out? So first, set up the instrument at A, take a vertical angle, and simultaneously take a stop reading on the benchmark, that is S1, and the vertical angle is alpha. Then move the theodolite. Set up at B, take vertical angle and the stop reading on the benchmark. That is S2, S1, alpha 1, alpha 2. Okay, then what is H1? What is S2? H1 is finding out the, that is the height that we are going to find out through the angle alpha 1, and this is H2 from the instrument axis to the top of our tower. Okay, from station B, that is H2, and from station A, the instrument axis, from the instrument axis to the top of tower, that is our H1 from instrument A, and H2 from instrument B. And we know the distance between A and B points, that is a small b, and we don't know the distance between A and our structure, that is capital D. Okay, we are going to find out the capital D, then H1, H2, and the RL of point Q. These are our aim. Okay, what is our aim? The first aim is finding out the RL of Q. For that, we need H1, H2, and our distance D. When we find out the distance D between A and our structure, that is Q, we get the height of that structure. Okay, from that our instrument line, we get H1. When we get H1, we can find out the RL of Q. We know the RL of benchmark. Then adding H1 plus H1, we get the RL of Q. For that, we need to know the what is D, capital D, and H1 for checking the RL of point Q. We need H2. Okay, this is the whole process we are going to find out. First, what is H1? How can we get the H1? H1 is equals to, from the triangle, this triangle Q, Q1, and suppose this is A. Okay, Q1, Q, and this is A, point A, this is H1, this is D. What is H1? D. Okay, this is our alpha angle 1. So tan alpha 1 is equals to opposite, that is H1, by D adjacent. We want H1. Okay, H1 is equals to cross multiply D tan alpha 1. Okay, we find out the formula for H1, that is D tan alpha 1. For H2, similarly, H2 is equals to, in that case, the distance, here the distance is D, but here the distance is adding as small b. So, small b plus D, and the alpha is changing, the angle is changing. The angle is theta 2, tan alpha 2. This is our angle, this is our H2. H1 and H2 we have find out. The main aim is, for getting the H1, we need capital D. For calculating the capital D, okay, here see the difference between H2 and H1. H2, from here to here it is H2. Here to here it is H1. H2 minus H1 gives the H2 minus S1, that is, gives the reading as S. H2 minus H1 is equals to, S1 is higher value, so I am taking S1 first. S1 minus S2 is equals to S. Okay, substitute this, h1 and h2 value in this equation 1. By substituting these two values in equation, we get the D. See how S is equals to H2. What is H2? Capital B, small b plus capital D tan alpha 2. And what is H1? Minus H1 is D tan alpha 1. Okay? Then, opening the bracket, B tan alpha 2 plus capital D tan alpha 2 minus D tan alpha 1. This is S. I need D. So that S, I am taking this side, S minus B tan alpha 2 is equals to, taking common from these two elements, D as tan alpha 2 minus tan alpha 1. Okay, then D is equals to S minus B tan alpha 2 by tan alpha 2 minus tan alpha 1. Okay, this is the formula we have derived. From what equation? From this equation. If we substitute above these two values in this equation, then we get as capital D as S minus B tan alpha 2 by tan alpha 2 minus tan alpha 1. We know the S, we know the B, alpha 2, alpha 1. So we can easily get as D. When we get as D, substitute in this this formula, that is H1. If we get the H1, we can easily find out the RL of the point Q. Let's see what is the formula. RL of Q is equals to, this is RL of benchmark plus S1 plus H1. We can easily get the RL of Q. See, this is the RL of benchmark. Then I am adding the S1. I am at this level. Then I am going like this. Then I am adding H1. Then I get the RL of Q. This is the formula how to calculate the RL of Q. Let's see a problem. On this case, it is a problem, okay? First, in the exam, the question will be given as, okay? Well, the question will be like this. Instrument at A, at B, and the vertical angle was given, and the stop reading, and the RL of given. So, how to draw this figure? First, you analyze the question. You have to assume where will be the station A, station B, and how to substitute the values, okay? As the vertical angle is more at A, so the station A is at higher level, okay? And at station B, the vertical angle is less, so it is far away from our station A. As the vertical angle is less when compared to A, it is very far away from our point Q. And the stop reading, it is higher. The S1 is greater. So the station A is higher level. And the station B is, the stop reading is lower. So station B is at a lower level. And the RL of BMs are given, the distance between them were given. So just I am substituting that values in the figure. What is that? 25 degrees, 23 minutes, 16 degrees, 40 minutes, 1.350, 1.225. Okay, and the RL of BM has 152.26 meter. This is given, and the B has 30 meter. So let's do the problem. First, we have to calculate the capital D. If you know the formula, if you buy out the formula, it's good. If you don't know, just derive from the our previous steps. How to derive, I will tell you. Derive the formula for D. That is, D is S plus D tan alpha 2 by tan alpha 2 minus tan alpha 1. I'm substituting the value. S is the difference of two stop rating. What is that? S is equals to S1 minus S2. I'm substituting the S value, B value, tan alpha 2 value and tan alpha 1 value in the D formula. Then I get that D has 50.6 meters, where tan alpha 2 is tan 16 degrees 40 minutes and tan alpha 1 is tan 25 degrees 23 minutes. So I get that value as 50.6 meters. Then I have to find out the H1 value. H1 value, what is the formula? D tan alpha 1. D is 50.6 tan, what is alpha 1? 25 degrees 23 minutes. That I get the answer as 24 meters. Okay, I get the answer as 24 meters. Then it is easy. So find out the RL of Q, that is equals to first RL of BM, 152.26 plus S1. What is the value of S1? 1.350. 1.350 plus I have reached this line. Then I have to add H1. What is H1? 24 meters. This is the way I get my RL of Q. But before that, I want to find out H2. What is H2? B plus small b plus d. That is, this value is 80.6. Okay? Small b is our 30. 30 plus 50.6, 80.6 into tan alpha 2. I get the answer as 24.18 meter. Okay? The H2 is 24.18 meter. For checking the answer, I am again finding the RL of Q. Then RL of Q is equals to RL of which one is 152.26 plus I am adding S2, that is 1.225 plus H2, 24.18. Yes, if you add this value and this value, you will get an answer as 177.61 meters. 177.61 meters. If you get both the values are equal, then your calculation is correct. Otherwise, recheck the problem where you have done a mistake. Okay? This is the way you have to find out the complete, how to find out the RL of Q. First, calculate the D. Then H1, H2, with the help of H1, find out the RL of Q. With the help of H2, find the RL of Q. If both the values are equal, then your answer is correct. In some cases, our station A is below the station B. Okay? In our previous case, station A is higher than the station B. But in this case, station B is lower than the station A is lower than the station B. Then what is the formula of D? The formula of D is S plus B tan alpha 2 by tan alpha 1 minus tan alpha 2. There is only a sign difference between that case and this case, and other things are same, similar. Okay? The capital D formula is, in that case, S minus B tan alpha 2. In this case, S plus B tan alpha 2. Okay, this is the difference between that case and this case. So, see this problem. There is instrument, stations are given, stop ratings are given, vertical angles are given, RL of benchmark is also given, and the distance is given. Try this. If you have any queries, post in a comment. And thank you for watching the video. Please like, subscribe and share the video.